Hello everybody and welcome to English Ambassador. And today we have this article about J.K. Rowling, who has gotten into trouble because apparently she said that men were men and women were women. Ooh, major crime alert. So, let's see what we have to say here, shall we? Harry Potter author J.K. Rowling under fire again for extreme anti-transgender rhetoric. Yes. Because these people are so fragile that you can't even tell them what they actually are in case they have a total mental breakdown and their little bubble collides with reality and all of a sudden they just explode. That's what happens. That's what actually happens to a trans person if you call them the wrong gender. They explode. So be careful. All these explosions you're hearing everywhere. What did you think they was like Islamic terrorism, for fuck's sake? No. It's transgender people being called the wrong gender and fucking exploding in public. That's what all this terrorism is. Tell you, it's a big conspiracy, man. Islamic terrorism doesn't even fucking exist. It's just transgender people exploding because someone called them a man when they actually think they're a woman. That's what it is. For sure that's what it is. I know that's what it is. What, do you think I'm crazy? Anyway, although the Harry Potter series was once considered holy text by the anti-Donald Trump resistance, its author, J.K. Rowling, has been under fire by her progressive for her trans-exclusive language and for her sins against modern gender theory. Back in December, Rowling was cancelled online for daring to note that biological sex is real. As we all know, it's real. Even the people who are pretending that it's not real know that it's real. They're pretending that it's not real. They know that it's real, which is why they want to be the opposite, because it's real. If none of it was real, you wouldn't care that you had a penis or how everybody saw you anyway, because it would just be the way that it is. But you're trying to force everybody to see you as the opposite to what you are, because you as well know that it's real. It's embedded in your own belief system, you dumb fuck. Anyway, back in December, Rowling was cancelled. We've just read that. Force data, who was stripped of her... Oh, because she came to the defense of university professor Maya Forstater, who was stripped of her job after tweeting that a person cannot change their biological sex. So a professor lost her job in a university for stating facts about biology, and you lose your job in a university, and this is where we're sending our kids to learn shit. Righty-ho. Now, seriously, this person lost their job for stating a basic fact about biological science. Now, you can play in your pretend world of pretend things as much as you fucking want, but it doesn't change biological reality. Your penis can't magically suddenly transform into a vagina, and that just makes you what? It's just not real. And you know it's not real because you have to actually physically change your body to have something that looks like a imitation of the real thing. Anyway, now I'm gonna yes, I'm really really transphobic. No, I'm not afraid of you. You can do whatever the fucking hell you want. But reality is fucking reality. Okay, right now Rowling is in trouble again after she liked a tweet about a Welsh trans woman whom a writer referred to as an adult human male who claims to be a lesbian. Yeah, well, I'm a lesbian too because I love women. Anyway. LGBTQ Nation reports that Rowling liked a tweet by anti-transgender activist Fred Sargent, a writer who objects to the idea that anyone can somehow change their biological sex and believes that male to female transgender individuals cannot be oppressed because they are born biologically male and made a choice to exit the patriarchy. Yeah, but don't give it to them, mate. Don't even give them the idea of patriarchy. There's no fucking patriarchy. But yes, that's a good point. You chose your oppression. Oh, but we didn't choose to be this way or identify this or whatever, whatever. Oh. Sargent tweeted about a transgender activist named Alex Drummond and described Drummond's lack of biological transition in great detail, adding that Drummond, who considers themselves a woman attracted to other women, so technically a lesbian, believes that real lesbians who aren't into penises are transphobic and should be excluded from the lesbian community. So actual lesbians are fake lesbians. Because I think you tend to become a lesbian because you don't like penis. I think it's the general dislike of penis that makes you become a lesbian. You know? And I can get on board with the lesbians, you know? I'm not a big fan of penis. But, you know, if you don't like penis, that, you know, that's kind of the definition of a lesbian. So you're going to force a lesbian to suck your lesbian penis because otherwise she's a bigot. Like, do you even hear yourselves when you talk? Do you even hear yourselves when you talk? You cannot imagine that this lesbian doesn't want to be with you because you're a man. And she knows you're a man. We know you're a man. Everybody knows you're a man. Even the ones that are pretending to not know that you're a man know that you're a man. And if they had some doubts, if you look really, really, really like a woman and you act really, 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 really like a woman, and all of a sudden you take your drawers off and you have a penis, then they know. And they can't just pretend, oh, look, there's a rather enlarged clitoris with some extra balls hanging down there. No, you're not a fucking lesbian. And a lesbian isn't gonna want to lick those balls now, is she? It just seems like common sense. Because the whole reason she became a lesbian in the first place was because of her dislike for male genitalia. Anyway, moving on. Sargent later crowed that the tweet had received a like from Rowling, setting off the progressive social media chorus. Rowling, many progressives and gender activists believe, is a TERF, or trans-exclusionary radical feminist, a brand of activist that has cropped up more in Europe than in the United States, but which fights back against the idea that gender is fluid or non-existent, a theory they believed to be a threat to the crusade for women's rights. If gender is merely a social construct, then the goals of feminism are and were imaginary, and feminist achievements were in vain. Yeah, I think in general, and not everywhere, but I do feel like in general, here in Europe, we have a little bit more common sense, and we find it a little bit more difficult to just accept that a man is a woman. And I feel like most of the women, and this isn't a scientific study, I just feel like even transgender people, not all of them, because some of them are insufferable here as well, I feel like, you know, maybe here they're just like, well, no, you can see me that way if you want to see me, but, you know, we're just getting on with our lives, I'm doing whatever the hell I want to do, and you can do whatever the hell you want to do, I'm not going to force you to suck my penis. Saying that, you can get arrested in this country for saying the wrong thing to the wrong person, which is problematic. It's problematic. I mean, if you can't even teach biology without being transphobic, where the hell are we going? Political correctness is fucking everywhere. Can we just drop it? Can we just drop it? Can we just use our common fucking sense? Anyway, back in December, in support of Maya Forstater, Rowling tweeted, "Dress however you please, call yourself whatever you like, sleep with any consenting adult who will have you, live your best life in peace and security, but force women out of their jobs for stating that sex is real?" Yes, it's insanity. And everybody has allowed it by just letting it fucking happen and going, oh yes, yes, you're oppressed, and caressing everybody in, you know, what do you call it? You know, don't ruffle any feathers, you know. Oh, everybody be tolerant, you know. Yes, very, very tolerant. Because these are the tolerant people. The guy who cannot accept that a lesbian won't suck his penis is the tolerant one. Right. Okay. Where the hell are we? Where the hell are these people in your head? If you're listening, where are you in your head? Where are you to think that you are the tolerant one when you cannot be tolerant of the of the idea that a lesbian, a person who doesn't like penis, won't suck your penis? I can't believe that this is even something that gets talked about. It's like, fucking hell. I suppose it's my fault for talking about it in the first place. Anyway, Rowling was quickly derided as a bigot, and legions of Harry Potter fans took to Twitter to exoriate, whatever the hell that means, I don't know what that means, Rowling for her personal beliefs, though it's not entirely clear what Rowling's personal beliefs actually are. Well, here's what I think happened. I think Rowling tried to cuddle up to the progressives, and the progressives went, Rowling is on our side, yeah. But then when Rowling sort of a sudden had a spell of common sense that just smacked her in the face, she went, actually, you know, men are kind of men and women are kind of women, and just because you lop your penis off, it doesn't make you a woman. It's a little, you know, the idea of woman is a little bit, you know, maybe a little bit more precious than just lopping your penis off. At best, it makes you a eunuch. But it doesn't make you a woman now, does it? Anyway, some even called for a boycott of the Harry Potter books. Celebrities who made the mistake of liking Rowling's offending tweet were even themselves made to apologise. Rowling has not issued a statement on the subject. In the past, her publicist has said that Rowling likes things on Twitter by mistake. That's a bit of a cop-out, isn't it? You know? What is this? Every day, there's a new case of political correctness gone too far. Every case, every day, you think that common sense couldn't get any more drained down the toilet, and then something like this just comes along and happens. What do you think about this? Do you think that I should be allowed to force a lesbian to suck my penis? It only seems fair. What is these lesbians being all selfish and shit, refusing to suck penis? Who do they think they are? Who do they bloody well think they are? You know, what about all these straight women refusing to lick vagina, huh? About them. How intolerant can you be? Fucking bigots. Suck the penis, you bigot. I don't know what else to say. I've probably already said too much. That's about it from me. Subscribe and shit.